South Korea and the U.S. announced their first confirmed coronavirus cases at virtually the same time in late January. If you take a look at where we are right now in the U.S. now has 50 times more cases and almost 100 times more fatalities than South Korea. Meanwhile, while the U.S. makes up only about 4.25% of the world's population, the U.S. has 30% of the world's reported coronavirus cases and almost 20% of the reported coronavirus deaths. Sanjay Gupta said this is all because we got started too late in the U.S. Is that right? Do you agree?
You know, it isn't as simple as that, Jake. I'm sorry. I mean, to just say this is all happening because we got started too late. Obviously, if you look, could you have done something a little bit earlier? Would have had an impact, obviously. But where we are right now is the result of a number of factors. The size of the country, the heterogeneity of the country. I think it's a little bit unfair to compare us to South Korea, where they had an outbreak in Daegu and they had the capability of immediately, essentially, shutting it off completely in a way that we may not have been able to do in this country. So obviously, it would have been nice if we had a better head start, but I don't think you could say that we are where we are right now because of one factor. It's very complicated, Jake.
The New York Times reported yesterday that you and other top officials wanted to recommend social and physical distancing guidelines to President Trump as far back as the third week of February, but the administration didn't announce such guidelines to the American public until March 16th, almost a month later. Why?
You know, Jake, as I've said many times, we look at it from a pure health standpoint. We make a recommendation. Often the recommendation is taken, sometimes it's not. But it is what it is. We are where we are right now.
Do you think lives could have been saved if social distancing, physical distancing, stay-at-home measures had started third week of February instead of mid-March?
You know, Jake, again, it's the what would have, what could have. It's very difficult to go back and say that. I mean, obviously, you could logically say that if you had a process that was ongoing and you started mitigation earlier, you could have saved lives. Obviously, no one is going to deny that. But what goes into those kinds of decisions is complicated. But you're right. I mean, obviously, if we had right from the very beginning shut everything down, it may have been a little bit different. But there was a lot of pushback about shutting things down back then.
Team, subscribe for more of these type of videos.